إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد، فيقول الحق سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, as I always remind you about this day, the day of Jum'ah, the khutbah of Jum'ah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah and our ta'ah and our reminder. And after saying this, our khutbah today, our reminder today, is going to be about fadl al-du'a, the benefit, the virtues for the du'a. What benefit will have from the du'a for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم: ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. الله سبحانه وتعالى, he said in the Quran, very for sure, ذلك, and word ذلك, it means it is something at sure. ذلك لأن الله هو الحق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in every matter, He is the haqq, He is the truth. And everything else, other than the ibadillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is batil, is false. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is al-Ali, He is the most greatest one. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He described Himself, His sifat, His asma. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran about al-du'a, and the ulama mentioned in the tafsir, the explanation of this ayah, they said, if no other ayat and no other hadith comes after this ayah, it will be enough. As He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling His messenger, His prophet, محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, if your ummah, the one you call them to the tawheed, to this aqidah, the aqidah of deen al-Islam, if anyone ask them, if anyone asked you about me, about my jalal, about my names, tell them I am close to them. And if you need to ask, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only alone. The other ayat, and the Mufassirin explain, every time anyone anyone went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asked him a question, the answer come in this form. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّةِ. As example in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّةِ. They asked you about the moon. قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدُ قُلْ هِيَ مَوَاقِيتُ لِلنَّاسِ وَالْحَجِ. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ. قُلْ مِنْ سَيْ يَا مُحَمَّدُ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالُ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. So many ayat in the Quran comes in this form. Anytime, anyone went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they have any question, the form of the answer, Ya Muhammad, say to them, the answer is so and so and so. But this is the only ayah in Quran. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he didn't tell him, Ya Muhammad, tell them, I am close to them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wanted to tell you, there is no one, there is no makhluk, there is no one at all between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your ibadah, in your dua. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, wal hadith in Tirmizi, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah. Du'a is ibadah. Is ibadah. So the Muslim should pay attention when you make dua. This is part of your ibadah. Even the other dua, the other hadith, which is narrated by Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, when hadith comes in the Bukhari, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man lam yas'al Allah yaghdab alayhi. If you don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be angry at you. Because he's the only one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the only one, he's able to give you. So here, the lesson of this, we don't ask the makhluk. Because even the makhluk promise you to do something, but maybe later, he's gonna leave this dunya. He's gonna pass away. He will not be alive no more. So he will not be able to fulfill his promise. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's al-hayy. He's al-hayy. He's al-hayy al-qayyum. After saying that, to remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the most rich one. As he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya ayyuhal nas. And this call comes to the all mankind. Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya ayyuhal nas. Antum al-fuqara'u ila Allah. Wallahu huwa al-ghaniyu al-hamid. We are the one who in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are a poor one. Doesn't matter how much you have, but trust me, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent little of ibtila to any of us, do you think what do you have would help you to cure the ibtila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send you? Sometimes you have just headache. And let's say you have everything. Who will cure that headache? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing will help you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows we are in need to Allah. So do not even think that once you have something, you became so powerful. You have the all qudra. No, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuhal nas. أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد إن يشأ يذهبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله العزيز. الله سبحانه وتعالى if he will finish destroying all us Then if he wants, he's going to bring others. He's going to bring other creations who understood the ibadah, who understood that we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, the dua, as Allah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the next hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he feels shy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he feels the shy that you raise your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the dua, then he will leave you. And this comes in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيِّيٌ كَرِيمٌ. Two things, two صفات. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about himself, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيِّيٌ حَيَاءٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he shy that you raise your hands asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your need, your haja, kareem, his most generous one. يستحي إذا رفع الرجل إليه يديه أن يردهما صفرا خائبتين. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will feel, or he's gonna be shy, that the abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise his hands to Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will leave you. So this another reminder. If you have any hardship, if you need anything, straight go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make sure the relationship, the ilaqa between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is good enough as abd salih. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will answer your dua. See the ayat of Surah Al-Mujadila, when she went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي إلى الله والله يسمع تحاوركما إن الله سميع بصير. That woman went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and tell him something, some issues about her husband. You know what Aisha radiallahu anha said? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with that lady in one place, in the whole room, but both him, Rasulullah, Aisha radiallahu anha, and lady next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha radiallahu anha, she didn't hear exactly what the lady whispering and saying to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then she said in the end, Subhanallah, I was with them in the same room, I couldn't hear that conversation going on between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that lady. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he heard them min fawq sab'i samawat. So, you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's very close, he's very close to us. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. No one will be like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَا تُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارُ وَهُوَ يُدْرِكُ الْأَبْصَارُ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, no one has the ability to reach the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one has same ability, same power, same qudra to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he said, وَهُوَ يُدْرِكُ الْأَبْصَارُ. But he's able to see us, to hear us. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers, sisters, الدعاء is العبادة. Our دعاء is the عبادة. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد, I want all of you, listen, to this ayat, this surah, all of us, I believe, we memorize Surah Al-Ikhlas. We see carefully, it is a short surah. It's about a line. If you look at it in the Mus'haf, only a line. But the meaning, the topic of the surah, the value of the surah is great. قال سبحانه وتعالى قل هو الله أحد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. He's the only one. Allah is Ahad. I will not say قل هو الله أحد. I'm gonna starve. Leave قل. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's saying Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Muhammad, tell them قل. Say what he has to say. Allahu Ahad. Allah is one. الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying in this ayat, who's Allah سبحانه وتعالى? He's the only one you have to worship. You have to make sujood. You have to make rukur. You have to ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And you have to make sure that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is happy with you. Did you ever think that before you do anything, before any moves, before you say something, Allah is seeing me? Allah is watching me? You never concern and make sure I want myself always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeing me in something or any time or any moment. Allah is happy with me. Before you do any dhamb, any sin, do you ever think while you are doing this sin or this dhamb, Allah is gonna see you? What are gonna tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In the same moment, you doing any haram, Malak al-Mawt comes and take your ruh and you die in ma'asiyah. You die in ma'asiyah. Then, what are you going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the qabr? What are you going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in yawm al-qiyamah? If you die in the ma'asiyah, you end your life so many years past. Then you end it in the ma'asiyah. You end it in them. La ilaha illallah. Ta'ala Allah an thalik. Uluwan kabir. So, again, الدُّعَاء. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the du'a. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَا الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, as we use since the beginning of the khutbah, the ayat which is begin with قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ till your ummah. Ya ibadiya alladhina asrafu, those who didn't, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who didn't understand the ayat of Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ, those who didn't study, learn the lesson, the ma'ani, the meaning of the Surah Al-Ikhlas. And they did a lot of haram, a lot of dhunub, and they find out that the qabr is very close to us. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, part of his qudra, that if you come back to him with tawbah, with regret, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna forgive all of our dhunub, all of our sins. And you see the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is narrated by Abi Musa al-Ash'ari. Kunna ma'a Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi safar. Abi Musa al-Ash'ari is saying, we were with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a traveling. So while they are traveling, the Sahaba raising their voice saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and making dua too loud to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّكُمْ لَا تَدْعُونَ أَصَمَّ وَلَا غَائِبًا. You don't make dua to someone who's absent, or he will not be able to hear you. إِنَّمَا تَدْعُونَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. But you ask someone, you ask the one who hear and who see. والله الذي تدعون أقرب إلى أحدكم من عنق راحلته. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, the one you ask is closer to you than the animal you're riding. Of course, the time they don't have car, bus, train, plane, they use animal, they use horse, they use camels. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, the one you ask right now is closer to you than the animal you're riding at that moment. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانِ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's closer to you. He's seeing you. He hear you. And what is Habl al-Wareed? You see these veins here in your neck? These two veins here, one in the right, one in the left. And these two veins, their job is connecting the blood between the brain and the heart and the rest of the body. These two veins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He uses, as He said, Habl al-Wareed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, He's closer to you. He is closer to you than these veins. So now how much is close? How much is close? He's much closer than anything. Then when Abi Musa al-Ash'ari heard that, he said, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. We didn't know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, ألا أدلك يا أبا موسى على كنز من كنوز الجنة؟ Shall I tell you about one of the treasure of the Jannah? One of the kunuz, one of the wealth. Wealth. Just look for money, look to get rich. Shall I tell you about somehow to be rich in Jannah? He said, keep saying, keep saying, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Say it. Say it as much as you can. قال سبحانه وتعالى about لا إله إلا الله. And saying لا إله إلا الله. الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله. You want to look for happiness? You want to look for cure of any hardship? You're going with? Say la ilaha illallah. Say la ilaha illallah day and night. Make sure you're busy with azkar. You're busy with ibadah. Ala bi dhikri Allahi tatma'in al-qulub. After saying that, and I would like to ask the brother, inshallah, if you can, that corner, please leave it empty and come, leave up so the brother can come here for their salah, inshallah. Please make sure, and there is no talk, there is no salam, there is nothing during the khutbah in Yawm al-Jum'ah. Three conditions for the dua to accept by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will say, many of us, sometimes, we make in dua again and again and again and again. And we wait for the answer. And maybe after you make dua, no answer, you're going to say, I hear the ayat of Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ.
Allah said, I'm closer to you. But I make dua today, I make dua yesterday, and I will make it tomorrow. But there is no answer. What's going on? Which one is true now? Me or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that is the Quran? But I will kill you. You have to make sure before you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before you raise your hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make sure, check yourself. Check yourself first. That's why the ulama said there are some shuroot, some conditions has to be there before you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I will say, you have to ask Allah anyway. The first condition, al-ikhlas. Al-ikhlas, the sincerity. You have to be sure when you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your dua is khalis to Allah. How I can make my dua khalis to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I make sure when I make dua to Allah, I know for sure, I know for real that this dua has to be only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. I must have this aqidah, this belief. But I make dua, but have my feeling, have my belief somewhere else. There is no ikhlas. قال سبحانه وتعالى فادعوا الله مخلصين له الدين. Make sure your dua have the ikhlas. The other condition, إطابة المطعم. The food you eat, make sure it's halal. I'm gonna come with one riwayah. This way was kind of conversation, talk for a few minutes between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his wife. And please pay attention. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was laying down in the bed. While he's laying down, he find on his bed a date, single date. And I will add little here. If you go to now, after Jum'ah, after Salah, to a grocery store, and you pick up a single date and went to cash it, who is in charge for the cashier? How much is going to be? How much is going to take from you? It's going to smile. Let's go. How much is going to take from you? 1 cent? What's gonna make him so powerful? He doesn't need that. There is no price. There is no price. Because how much? It's not even anything. So, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his iman, his muraqabah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Aisha radiallahu anha, the Sahaba, asked her about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, How is the akhlaq? How is the manner of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And she said, Kana khuluquhu, his mu'amalat, his way, his bath, al-Quran. So of course, if someone is akhlaq al-Quran, he has to make sure before he does anything is matched with al-Quran. So after he ate these dates, you ask it, Aisha, Ya Aisha, I eat 1 date. I'm worried. If this date, I just put it in my stomach, which doesn't make me a hero, will not increase my weight, another 5 pounds. If you ate 5 dates now, it's going to make you full? No, you need another 10. He said, I scare if this date from mal al-sadaqah. Mal sadaqa. The brother, please, again, please move up. The brother standing. Come up, inshallah, please. The brother, please, move up here. Move up here with me, inshallah, here. Make a space for your brother, inshallah, to sit and listen to the rest of the khutbah. Quick, inshallah. So, you see how much Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he cares? Just for this small date, a single date, he ate. He's worried if this date part of mal sadaqa. So what he's gonna tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha rusulu, كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا. All you believe, all the messenger, all the mankind, eat from الطيبات. ده رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith. ثم ذكر الرجل يطيل السفر أشعث أخبر. ما أكله حرام، مشربه حرام، مذني بالحرام، فأنا يستجاب له. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, the one who raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, answer my dua, answer my dua. And there is no answer for the dua because ما أكل حرام، مشرب حرام، ملبس is حرام. What is dua you want now? Lastly, or the last condition after saying the first one, al-ikhlas, halal food, halal mashrab, halal malbas, al-yaqeen wa-thiqata billahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ud'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil-ijaba. You must, when you raise your hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the dua, you have to have iman, you have to have belief, Allah will answer your dua. But if you get any doubt, any shak in your dua, trust me, will not be answered. So you make sure, when you ask Allah, you have a yaqeen, you have the certainty that when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the dua, He will answer your dua. After saying all this, I would like to add a little reminder about khutbah al-jum'ah. We make sure, inshallah, when you come to salat al-jum'ah, don't come late. You miss the ajr of salat al-jum'ah. You lose the whole reward of salat al-jum'ah. Make sure you are in the masjid before the khatib take the minbar and begin the khutbah. Coming late after the khutbah begin, you're gonna lose, you're gonna miss the ajr of yawm al-jum'ah and salat al-jum'ah. And we didn't have jum'ah every day. We didn't have jum'ah in morning, jum'ah afternoon, jum'ah evening. It's only once a week. And make sure don't miss salat al-jum'ah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned this in one hadith. Who miss salat al-jum'ah? Three jum'ah is straight. Three jum'ah is straight. He didn't go to the masjid or he missed it. فَقَدْ خَلَعَ رِبْقَةَ الْإِسْلَامِ مِنْ عُنُقِ. He left the fall of Islam. So make sure, do not miss Salat al-Jum'ah. Be early for Salat al-Jum'ah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah. Allahumma taqabbal minna salatana, wa taqabbal minna du'a'ana, wa taqabbal minna ruku'ana, wa taqabbal minna sujudana. Allahumma akhtim bilbaqiyat salihati a'malana. Allahumma tawaffana wa anta radin anna. Allahumma tawaffana wa anta radin anna. اللهم اشف امراضنا اللهم اشف امراضنا وارحم امواتنا وارحم امواتنا اللهم ارحم اباءنا وارحم امهاتنا وبارك لنا في بيوتنا وازواجنا وذرياتنا اللهم اشف اولادنا اللهم اشف اولادنا اللهم بارك لنا في ذرياتنا اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اعداءك اعداء الدين اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه واتوبوا الى الله والحمد لله